My name is Dr. Lisa Beckley-Roberts, affectionately known as Dr. B-Rob, and I have the distinct honor of serving as interim chair for the Department of Music, where we are the home of the sonic boom of the South and so much more. Among that so much more are a number of hidden gems, such as our vocal area, that boasts a top performing chorale and concert choir that is fresh back from a tour of the Southeast where they wowed audiences, and one of the oldest and most successful opera workshop programs of any HBCU in the nation. Tonight, I am very happy to bring you greetings and to welcome you to the Jimmy James Jr. Recital Hall in the FD Hall Music Center. I am especially grateful for the opportunity to welcome our special guests from Alcorn State University. Please welcome you. And I am excited. Tonight's program celebrates African American women composers, and we stand united with Alcorn in understanding that when a sleeping woman wakes, mountains move. We understand that as we reframe the mission of our HBCUs, it is imperative that alongside Tchaikovsky and the classical music of Europe, we celebrate all of our classical musics. And we include jazz and blues and hip hop and R&B and African music and music of the entire diaspora. And that we recognize, celebrate, and encourage the prolific work of our women, who have always been the force which moves our mountains and creates the soundtrack of the nation. Thank you, Dr. Galbraith. Thank you, Dr. Alexander, for your hard work in reminding us of all of our genius. And thank you all for our guests for being here. I'd especially like to take a moment to recognize any guests that are visiting us from Alcorn. Please stand and let us recognize you. Are there any guests here? Now, on the football field, I know it's something different, but here in the FD Hall Music Center, you are welcomed. We are happy that you are here. We are sister schools supporting sister missions to support our children, our young adults, and the future leaders of our country. May I also acknowledge any elected officials who might be present, if there are any here? Well, I always want to make sure that I thank and acknowledge our administrators. I see President Dr. William B. Bynum is here. Acknowledge in absentia our Provost and Vice President, Dr. Linda Brown Wright, our Chief of Staff, Dr. Deborah Mage Jackson, a graduate of our music program, Dr. Joseph Whitaker, Associate Provost and Vice President of Academic Affairs, and our Dean, Dr. Mario Azevedo, in absentia, who is always a huge supporter of all of our work here in the music department. Thank you all for being here and enjoy this wonderful concert. And now, without any further ado, I'd like to introduce Mr. Ronald Hicks, our Graduate Assistant Director of the University Choirs.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, we celebrate the Sisters of Sound and Soul, the African-American female composers. When one asks the question of African-American composers, many direct their attention to those of the popular styles of the African-American music traditions of jazz, blues, hip-hop, R&B, and gospel. But it is important that we recognize that remnant of composers who fought their way to have a place in Western music traditions, especially for African-American women who fought insurmountable odds to claim their stake as a composer and arranger of standard concert music. Tonight is an iconic performance because we have two ensembles that are under the direction of the only two African-American female conductors at any public university in the state of Mississippi. And it is also powerful because the very house in which we stand and sit is under the administration of an African-American female scholar and performer. Throughout this evening, I will share with you biographical information about each and every one of the female composers that will be performed on tonight. And before we go into that, we want to invoke the spirit of our ancestors by singing the National Negro Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing, sung by Jackson State University's premier vocal male ensemble group, J6. Tonight, the Women's Chorus of Alcorn State University, under the direction of Dr. Alana Alexander, will perform Pamela Baskin Watson's My God Is So High.
My God is so high, you can't get over.
hailed choral anthems. Florence Price, praise the Lord. Tonight, they will perform for you Miss Powell's adaptation of Langston Hughes' poems, To Sit and Dream.
To sit and dream. I want God's Thank you.
form to the infamous HBCU anthem by Billy Jackson King, Psalm 57.
Oh.
Margaret Bonds' transcription, Negro Speaks of Rivers. Tonight's next piece is Professor Powell's transcription of a noted gospel song, Jesus is Marvelous, Praise the Lord. And we always want to close a concert with a rousing number that reminds you of the church house. So tonight we perform Stephanie Powell's He Is Marvelous, led by Jackson State University's Gavin Hughes and under the direction of Jackson State University's Dr. Loretta Galbraith. To do a choral benediction, and we definitely want to make a note for Mr. Laura, Dr. Kathy Pitts. If you are here, please stand. Tonight's choral benediction, at the behest of our director, Dr. Loretta Galbraith, we were dedicated to the memory of two very precious people to each of the groups. In October of 2018, the Alcorn State University Concert Chorale lost one of their members, Ms. Jayla Gray. And just recently, one of our choristers at Jackson State University, Laura Pitts, lost her father, an avid supporter of the Concert Chorale. So tonight's benediction, we dedicated to the memory of Ms. Jayla Gray and Mr. Pitts. Moses Hogan's we shall walk through the valley in peace. We ask each of you to leave with the peace of the Lord and also be blessed. Thank you.